Does nursing pharmacology just make you feel like you're going to go a little bit crazy in nursing school? Okay, a lot crazy in nursing school. I've got three tips to help make it better. Seriously, a lot better. Hey friend, my name is Christina Raffato from NursingSOS.com, and here on the Nursing School Show, we give you the tips and the resources that you need to become an amazing nurse. And today we are talking about nursing pharmacology. That's right, yes, that little subject we all wish just didn't exist in nursing school, right? I totally hear you. So as I was going through nursing school, there were three major nursing pharmacology hacks that I used to make it a whole lot better. And I am going to cover those right here in this video with you today. And I've also got a free pharmacology cheat sheet for you that you can download. So if you would like to check that out, I will put a link in the description below this video. So let's go over the three nursing pharmacology hacks. The first one is to learn the generic name of the drug. Did you know that most nursing school exams, including the NCLEX exam, actually don't use trade names or brand names for pharmacology questions? Sure, they might have them inside the question, but the generic name should always, always appear somewhere in the exam question as well. Now, here's why this is so important. There can be a ton of different trade names or brand names for a drug, but there's only one generic name. This means that you don't need to memorize all of those different brand names for the drug. You can just focus on remembering the generic name. So having only one thing to memorize for nursing pharmacology is a huge win, right? So make sure to focus on learning the generic name of the drug. Now, here's a little bonus tip for you that is part of our step-by-step process for learning pharmacology that you can go through in our free pharmacology course if you're interested. I will put a link to that in the description below this video as well. So if you want to check that out, that resource is there for you. So here's your little bonus tip. After you've learned the generic name of the drug, you will need to learn the class that drug belongs to. So a class of drugs is just a grouping of similar drugs. So when a few drugs belong to the same class, it tells you that they most likely they act the same in the body, and meaning that their mechanism of action is similar. So all of the drugs in that one drug class will have similar mechanism of action and similar side effects and things like that. So after you've learned the generic name, you'll want to learn its drug class. And this leads us into nursing pharmacology hack number two. Get familiar with the naming structure of medications, particularly the endings of the names. So the endings of the names of the drug. So oftentimes, generic drug names will have a similar structure that will tell you what drug class it belongs to. It's pretty awesome. So for example, medications that end in pril, P-R-I-L, like lisinopril, captopril, and enalapril, these are all ACE inhibitors. That's their drug class. So all of these medications, they end in pril, which tells you that they belong to that drug class of ACE inhibitors. Pretty cool, right? So this makes it super easy when you're taking an exam, because oftentimes you will see a medication that you've never heard of before. So don't freak out when this happens. Just stop for a minute, take a deep breath, and look at the name of the drug and see if it contains any components of other drug names that you're familiar with and could possibly be related to. You might just be able to figure out what class it belongs to or what it does just by actually comparing that name to other drug names that you already know. And finally, nursing pharmacology hack number three is, this is a big one, to learn the mechanism of action of the drug class. Now, most nursing students, including myself, we are guilty, right, of trying to memorize the mechanism of action for each individual drug that we're learning. Have you done this before? You spend hours and hours and hours trying to remember the mechanism of action for each individual drug so that you can learn what each drug does, right? Now, are you ready to have your mind blown? Because this is a secret nursing pharmacology hack. The mechanism of action of the drug class will tell you the mechanism of action of the individual medications within that drug class. Now, I'm going to repeat that to help it sink in because this is totally game-changing. All of the drugs within a drug class most likely have a similar mechanism of action. So you do not need to memorize the mechanism of action for each individual drug. You only need to learn the mechanism of action for the drug class that those drugs belong to. So if you know the mechanism of action of that drug class, you will have a pretty good idea of the mechanism of action for each of the individual drugs that belong in that drug class. Does that make sense? I really hope that's clear because this one nursing pharmacology hack will just save you a boatload of time studying in nursing school, which is what we're here to do, right? And those are your three nursing pharmacology hacks, plus a little bonus tip for you. Learn the generic name of the drug, learn what drug class it belongs to, learn the naming structure of common medication classes, and learn the mechanism of action for that drug class, not the individual drugs that are part of that drug class. Now, I've got a couple resources to help you out with all of this, and I put links to everything in the description below this video. So you've got a free cheat sheet and a free pharmacology course to help you out if you need it with nursing pharmacology. And if you need more help with nursing school, make sure to check out all of the other videos that we have as part of the nursing school show for you here on this channel. I really like to break down the concepts in nursing school super simple for you to help you really understand it and become the best nurse you can be. So if you need help, those are all there for you. Thank you so much for watching, friend. Now go become the nurse that God created only you to be. And I will see you right back here next time on the Nursing School Show. Take care.